Hello student, I am Smita Naikodi from YCIS Satara. Today I am going to teach you the topic having name Introduction to Polymer Chemistry. In our day-to-day life, we are familiar with the term polymer, or we are using the many things which are considered as a polymer. For example, plastics, elastomers, different types of fibers are the example of polymer. So we can say that, or in short, we can say that polymer is a one of the branch of chemistry, and we are living in the world of polymer. The term polymer, or what is meant by polymer? The polymer terms come from, or the polymer word is come from the Greek word poly means many and mers means small parts or units. Polymers are complex giant macromolecules made up from the repeating units which are derived from small units or small molecules called monomers. There is interlinking between these small units or small molecules to form larger molecule is known as polymers. The smaller part of the monomers, when link with each other and they converted into the higher molecular weight molecule, is known as polymer. Actually, polymers are high molecular mass macromolecules. They having somewhat 10^3 to 10^7 unit, that much higher molecular weight. There are both type of polymers are known, that is about organic polymers and inorganic polymers. In this chapter we are studying the organic polymers or aspects of organic polymer. Now next point is classification of polymers. Now first way to classify the polymers is on the basis of their source or origin. Now first type is natural polymers. The natural polymers are the polymers which are obtained from nature, or their sources are from the nature. For example, first type is a plant polymer and animal polymers. Plant polymers, for example, cotton or natural rubber, these are their sources are plants. Or animal polymers, for example, wool, silk. Here wool is obtained from hairs of sheep, or silk is obtained from silkworm. So they having source, that is from the nature or natural sources. So that's why these are the natural polymers. Now next type is synthetic polymer. Synthetic polymers are nothing but these are artificial polymers, or they are generated in the laboratory or in the industry, or they are man-made polymers. We can prepare it in the laboratory. For example, nylon, terephthalate, neoprene, these are the example of synthetic polymer. Now next, semi-synthetic polymers. Semi-synthetic polymers are actually natural polymers, but their properties are enhanced or modified with the help of some chemical reactions. So that's why these are known as semi-synthetic polymer. For example, cellulose acetate rayon or cellulose nitrate. Another way to classify the polymers, that is on the basis of their structure. The first type to classify on the basis of structure is linear or straight chain polymers. When monomer molecules are joined together in a linear arrangement, the resulting polymer is a straight chain polymers. When monomer molecules are joined together or linked together, they form longer straight chain molecule. Such a polymers are known as linear or straight chain polymers. It is obtained from bifunctional monomers or alkenes. The monomers which are considered with the linear or straight chain polymers are generally bifunctional monomers, means they having two functional groups present in the molecule. For example, polyvinyl chloride PVC, which containing double bond also and chlorine also, means two functional groups present in the molecule. The monomer of PVC is vinyl chloride. Vinyl chloride consists double bond and chlorine. So PVC having monomer vinyl chloride, from that the word comes polyvinyl chloride. The short form, we know that PVC, we use PVC pipes. This is a one of the example for polymer. Another example is HDPE, high density polyethylene. HDPE is nothing but high density polyethylene having monomer ethene, consists or it is alkene, means functional group is double bond alkenes. So that's why we can say that generally linear or straight chain polymers consist bifunctional groups, or these are obtained from bifunctional monomer and or alkenes. Now next type is, second type is branch chain polymers. Now branch chain polymers in which the monomers having three functional groups or already having side chain are known as branch chain polymers. These are nothing but the generally linear polymers having some branches, means these are further derivative of actually branch linear polymer. In branch chain polymer, we are obtaining the straight chain or linear chain along with some branches. See here, there are some branches. So such a polymers are known as branch chain polymer. For example, LDPE, low density polyethylene. Monomer of this polymer is ethene, but they having low density. That is a difference in between previous linear polymer and second one is a branch chain polymer. In linear polymer, there is high density polymers, and in a branch chain polymer, there is low density polymers. Or that's why we are taking example HDPE in a linear polymer, while LDPE in a branch chain polymer. Now third subtype from this is a cross-link polymers. The cross-link polymers are comes with some 3D arrangement or some cross-links. In this, cross-links are produced in a linear chain. See here, in this there are linear chains which are joined with each other through some cross-links. So such a polymers are known as cross-link polymers. For example, bakelite, melamine, these are some example of cross-link polymers.